I'm fascinated by what actually happens below the surface. I've always been that way since I was a child, and so being able to get underwater is a place where I like to be as much as possible. My name is Richard Sears. I work on cetaceans, and particularly large baleen whales. I've been working on whales since 1976, just that I'm going to do for 1 month what I really want to do and see what happens. And somehow, 41 years later, I'm still doing it. I knew I wanted to work on the ocean somehow, in some capacity. I mean, one of the reasons why I came to Canada was because I was hired to work on salmon for research stations. And then while I was there, that's when I saw my first blue whale. The thing that struck me the most were the blowholes, how big they were, and I felt I could have almost jumped in with both legs to one. You know, it just was that immense, and the power of the animal and all that really captivated me for those few moments that I was able to see it. Our everyday work consists of getting up in the morning and getting our gear ready and going out in the water. And these animals are so mobile, you need to be mobile as well. Because you need to get out in the water, you need a boat, obviously. You know, you have to, the whole idea is to study these animals where they live. Sometimes to do research on an animal, we see so little at the surface, it's very frustrating, because we would like to learn a lot more about them. I mean, sometimes I have a sort of fantasy that I can pull the plug and the water empties out and I can see where they all are, what they're doing. But, you know, the reality is not that, of course. And first step is to analyze the photographs. Blue whales are identified by the spots, or what we call modeling, on the body. Each species has its own unique pattern of color pigmentation. I have the crossbow, I have a specially designed arrow, and that arrow with a specially designed tip hits the whale. The arrow, the yellow part, acts as a stopper and then also as a floater. So once we've taken the sample, you take the sample out, put it in a tube, put it in a freezer, and then it's analyzed later on by geneticists. I would say the glamour part of the work is getting out in the water with the animals. That's what everybody wants to do. But once we've collected that data, then we have to spend a lot of time analyzing it. But when I'm in the field, if I've known the animal for a long time, I can recognize it the way I would a friend. A lot of people laugh when I say I'm going to retire, but I don't see myself sitting at home twiddling my thumbs. It's not really in my nature. You feel as though, even though your contribution's probably pretty slim, that you will have added just this much information to the overall knowledge on that species. And, you know, hopefully there'll be other generations of biologists that will continue it.